more idiotic. I see one of the most, well, actually several of the most un-American presidential things take place. President Biden. Oh, I even hate saying that. And no, this is not some Trump shoulda, woulda type shit. This is all some American shit. How dare you, sir? How dare you? First of all, you have the nerve to do this when we're bringing back 13 Marines who died because of your stupidity. Not ours, not the COs, but your stupidity. You had the nerve to do this.
Yeah, you know, we always say there's a difference between perception and reality. But when you say that, what matters is perception, not reality.
Sorry, y'all, I had to cut and light a cigarette for a second. This shit makes me so goddamn pissed. I can't even see straight. You're gonna do that during a dignified transportation because of a situation that was totally avoidable and your stupid ass caused. And now, it's coming out that you've been on the phone with the Afghan president going, oh, you gotta make this look good. You gotta make it look like this is working. How has this worked? You crazy old bastard. You lose 13 Marines, and then you wanna act like everything's fine. Not always well. And nothing is wrong with us. All the things that are wrong are inside your old ass head. You belong in a nursing home somewhere, but all y'all wanted Trump gone so goddamn bad, you rigged the election and now we're here. And I don't tell everybody. Those of y'all that voted for Biden and realized what a fuck up it was, cool, welcome to the team. But those of y'all that are backing a guy that has caused one of the biggest U.S. military casualties to date, has left $85 billion of military equipment over there in the hands of the Taliban, and is now trying to cover it up. And y'all are sitting there going, oh, everything's fine, da-da-da-da-da, all is well. You realize what country this is, don't you? It's the United States of fucking America. The country that when we get fucked with, we like you are like a goddamn Christmas tree and keep our boots on your neck until you know not to fuck with us no more. Not advocating violence at all whatsoever, but sometimes you gotta get dirty and do shit you don't wanna do to see the results that need to be seen. And the people that are saying we shouldn't have been over there in the first place and we were just over there for oil, do me a favor. Why don't you go over there if it's so goddamn great the way you think it is? And see how you act. actually get treated over there, you don't agree with their extremist bullshit. But no, you won't. And you know why you won't? Because you'll talk on the internet and you'll talk on social media. Because it's safe. And you don't have to back up what you say. I don't understand this at all. There's people that'll say they'll defend this until they die for a reason. Because they know where we should be. And this ain't it. Hopefully y'all that wanted it are happy. This is fucked.